Welcome back, everyone. So I have a strength workout for you today. It is a beginner workout, but you can modify it and definitely make the exercises harder. So follow along. We'll be doing some hip exercises, a lot of body weight. We will be needing a set of dumbbells. So if you have your dumbbells handy, that would be great. A chair would also be really handy for a lot of the exercises. You don't need it, but it definitely helps for some of the movements. For some of the stuff that where we will be using the chair, you can also get on the floor and make it much harder. So I'll explain it as we go along. But first of all, we are going to start with a little bit of a warm up. So let's just bring the knees up high just to get that body ready for doing some of the sit to stands or squats, whatever you wish to do. And then let's just bring the feet back and forth. Let's just bring the arms up and down. So just stretching them out a little bit here. If you want, you can do alternate arms if you find this too difficult on your shoulders. And then bring the arms out to the side and down. And then rotating the shoulders back. That's good. Okay, let's do the one where we hold on to the wall and we bring one leg up and back. So just do it slowly so you don't pull anything. And let's do it one more time. Good. And then switching to the other side. So going in front and back. And last one. Good. Okay, so we're gonna start with our sit to stands or a squat. So if you wanna make it harder, you know how to do the squat. Otherwise, we're gonna do the sit to stands with the chair. So you're just sitting down and coming back up. Go at your own pace. We're going to do about 10 repetitions for most of the exercises. So let's get started. So sitting down and coming up. That's one. So if you're doing the squat, you can definitely choose the depth that you want to go to. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight, nine, and last one, and 10. Okay, so here's where you can use a chair or you can just hold onto the wall. We're gonna do some exercises for our hips, which a lot of people want to do. So if you want to have it be more advanced, you can lie down on the floor. So I'd highly recommend that if you can get onto the floor because it does make the exercise quite a bit harder. So if you're lying on the floor, just have your head resting on your arm. So you're just lying on your side and then bringing your leg up. And if you're standing, you're just following me. So we're just going to put all of our weight onto one leg. Have that knee soft, okay, that's supporting you. And then you're just bringing the leg out to the side. Ready? So we're gonna do it 10 times. If you find 10 is too hard, if you feel like, oh, it's just too much for your hip, then just go up to 7, 8, or whatever it is that you're comfortable with and stop and then continue with the next exercise. Let's go. It's going out and in. Don't worry about going out really far either. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now keep that foot there and we're doing circles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Switching in the other direction. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And relax those legs for a second. That's quite a hard exercise, just shaking the legs out a little bit. And then we're gonna do them in a little bit of a faster movement. So just bringing that leg out and just pulsing a bit. So going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Good, so now switching to the other side. So if you're on the floor, you're switching to the other side as well. So again, if you found that really difficult, just instead of doing 10, just do less. Ready? So going out to the side first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now let's do the circles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Other direction. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Give those legs a little bit of a break. And then let's do the pulsing one. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And relax those hips, give them a bit of a break. And we'll do another set of the squats or sit to stand. Okay, you ready? Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Good. Okay, going into a glute squeeze or calf raise. Again, you can hold onto the wall if you want to. For those of you who are on the floor, well, obviously you're not on the floor anymore because you did the squats. Okay, so we're doing the calf raise and the glute squeeze. You're going to be squeezing the glutes, so go ahead, squeeze those glutes, bring those heels up and down, release the squeeze. Okay, that's one. Ready? Squeeze and lift and down. 3, and down, squeeze those glutes. 4, and down, and squeeze. 5, and down, this is 6, and down, 7, and down, 8, we've got 2 more, 9, and last one, and 10. Good. Okay, shake those legs out a little bit. Okay, for the next one, we are bringing that foot back. So toes go are on the floor, and we're just bringing that heel up. So foot is back fairly far. So you're thinking about squeezing or tightening your hamstrings here. So you're just bringing the heel to your glutes, okay? So just bring it up, feel that squeeze right here. Bring the toes down, and again, this is 2. And down. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 3 more. 8, 9, and 10. Good. Shake those legs out. And then switch to the other side. So bring the toes back. Bringing the heel to the glutes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 3 more. 8, 9, and last one, and 10. Good. Okay, getting the chair out of the way. Grabbing onto one dumbbell. So anywhere between a 5 and an 8 would probably be appropriate, depending on where you're at. So having the feet a little bit wider than shoulder width apart, you are going to have one foot going back a little bit, so a bit of a staggered stance. The weight is at the hip of the foot that is back, okay? You're trying to keep your arms fairly straight, and we're just going to bring the weight up and then bring it back down. So this is an ab exercise. Think about throwing a hay bale. I grew up on a farm, so I know what that's like. So just bringing the arm up and over and then back down. Okay, ready? Let's start together. 1, 2, three. You can lift that heel, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and last one, and 10. Good. Okay, switching to the other side. So feet are wide here. Bring one foot back. Weight is at the hip. And then bring the heel up. One. Two. Trying to keep the arms fairly straight. Three. Four. Five. Six, seven, eight, and two more, nine, and 10. And bringing that weight down. That one's a lot harder than it looks, I find. Okay, going into our back row, most of you know the back row by now, so grabbing onto two weights. Back is flat, hips are back. And then just rowing the weight up. Ready? So squeezing your upper back as you bring that weight up. So flex and down. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. And three more. Eight. Nine. And 10. Good. Okay, going into a bicep curl, let's just take a bit of a breather. So taking a nice deep breath in and breathing out. Good. Okay, weight is in front, elbows are fairly close to your body. So going into that bicep curl, so lifting that weight up, going overhead, up, back to the shoulder, and down. Knees are soft here, okay, your legs are supporting you. Ready? And up. That's two, three, four, five, six. So do as many as you can. We're going to go up to 10, but just do as many as you can. Seven. Eight, nine, and last one, and 10. Okay, going into that tricep kickback, so you might need a lighter weight for the triceps just because it is not as big of a muscle. So pick up that lighter weight if you need to. Ready? So leaning forward, bring that weight up. Kicking that weight back and back down. So going up to 10 here. That's three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and last one, and 10. Good. Okay, going into our standing twist. So putting one of the weights down. And then bringing the weight in front. Working on our abs here, so having the weight here. And you're just twisting to the side, thinking about keeping your abs tight. Ready? So twisting and come forward. So make sure you're breathing. Think of pulling your belly button in, keeping those abs tight every time you're twisting. Let's do a few more. And last time on the other side. Good. Okay, putting that weight down. Do doing one more set of squats or sit to stands, whichever you want to do. Ready? So do the squats if you can, find the depth that works best for you, and let's go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and two more, nine, last one, and 10. Okay, so here is where you can do the push-ups on the wall or push-ups on the floor, and then finishing with our plank, and that's it. So don't be intimidated. If you can't get on the floor, that's totally okay. You can do it on the wall. So you're just doing the push-ups off the wall. I often don't show it just because of the space in this room. It doesn't work that well, but I think you know what I mean when I say a push-up off the wall. In other words, you're doing it from the floor, either on your knees or a full push-up, whatever you're able to do. Obviously do the one that's harder if you can manage it. Okay, so I'll be doing them on the floor today on my knees, and then we'll go right into our plank and you are done. Okay, I'm just gonna move the chair out of the way. And let's get into position. So we're just going to do 10 today. If you want, you can do more. Ready? And let's go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. I'll give you a little bit of a breather and then we'll do the plank for 30 seconds. By all means, hold it longer if you can. Okay, let's do it. So you can also do this off the wall. Ready and go. One, that's 10, 20, and that's 30. So coming out of that, we're gonna stand up, we're gonna do some stretching, and then we're all finished. So let's do a stretch first of all for the hips, just because the hips, often you'll feel this a little bit later from doing those side leg raises. So we're just going to reach to one side. You're just gonna press that hip out a little bit, just to feel it more in that hip area. And coming out of that, let's reach in the other direction, just pressing that hip out a little bit more. And let's do it again without exaggerating the hips. So just reaching now and just feeling a nice stretch down through your side. Other direction. Good, let's just bring the hands together, clasping them in front and pressing forward, feeling that through your back. And then other side, feeling it through the front, through your chest. So bringing the hands up as much as you can to feel it more. And let's just bring one arm in front, crossing into front to feel that in your shoulder. So you can do these exercises every second day and you will really start to see a difference in your strength, especially if you're not doing any strengthening exercises now. Other side, or even doing the exercises twice a week, that would be great. Doing some kind of strength training is better than not doing any. And these are definitely really good exercises, and it's a nice quick workout, which is beneficial, or which is nice as well. Okay, just moving the arms back and forth. Let's just bring one arm up, one arm down, feeling that stretch this time, so really feeling that, and then switching to the other side. do that one more time on each side. So holding, and the other side again. Good, bringing those shoulders back. And that is it, you are done. If you want, you can do some leg stretches as well just to finish it off nicely, and definitely add in some cardio if you have time and if you're able to today. Thank you so much for joining me. I will see you next time. Bye for now.